always a delight to have you join us on another action-packed edition of Sports Tonight on Channels Television. We're broadcasting live from our sports center in Lagos, Nigeria. My name is Austin Okonakwa, and I'm standing in for Toyin Ibitoye. Welcome. On the show tonight, we'll be discussing Match Day 6 fixtures in the Nigeria Professional Football League and Match Day 11 of the Nigeria National League. Followers of domestic football are looking forward to the doubleheader this Sunday in Kano when champions Kano Pillars will file out against newcomers Taraba Football Club. Emba and tabletoppers Akwa United is also a good fixture. We will talk about it tonight. The Flying Eagles played another draw against Morocco as they continue preparations for the 2015 African Youth Championship qualifiers. Remember, on Wednesday, Coach Manu Garba team played a 2-2 draw against the Junior Atlas Lions, and today's game ended in a 1-1 draw. Now, after that match, Coach Garba says the Morocco equalizer was a soft one, telling his team not to let in such goals. Also, remember, he says he will be disappointed if his team does not win that game. Also, we'll talk about the Golden Eagles preparations for the WAFU Invitational Tournament in Togo. The draw for the UEFA Champions League and the Europa League has been done. Real Madrid will take on defending champions Bayern Munich. Wow, what a game that one will be. Chelsea will try to end Atletico Madrid's unbelievable Champions League journey. We cannot wait to see that one. In the final lap of the show tonight, we'll talk darts and chess and analyst Joachim and Babatunde will be joining us for that one. Action packed for the sport, and we invite you to this fun-filled journey. How can you be part of it? You know our feedback mechanism. It hasn't changed. On Twitter, we're channels_sports. On Facebook, we're channels-sports. So much to talk about tonight, and we would like to have you, you know, do it with us on the program. We will begin from home, talking about domestic football, Anna. Who else can start off the show with us other than Zoom Nodio Kunta? Zoom, it's good to have you on the show.
Yeah, good evening, Austin.
Okay, Match Day 6 of the Nigeria Professional Football League. It's not controversial. But what are we saying as regards that abandoned game between El Kanemi and Bayelsa United?
Well, decision has been made. That the punishments have been meted out based on that decision.
Yeah.
And even the LMC came out with, of course, from the reports we're hearing that Bayelsa has been banished to, they will play their next three home games in Abuja.
Wow.
For that, I think for the encroachment onto the pitch, because that's a breach of security. After that goal was called, we saw from the pictures in that encounter against Ekenemi. So it goes to show that, that sometimes when you look at the way football is being played here in Nigeria, you just have to go. Coming goal is quite interesting, it's quite exciting, but don't take it overboard. Don't go haywire.
The excitement is there, but there should be some sort of crowd control measures
Crowd control measures. So, but we'll get the full details in the coming days. But so far, but it's just a sketchy information that we to get from the league organizers.
Okay, some exciting fixtures to look forward to this weekend. I don't know about you, but I think on Saturday, Enyimba Football Club, and to an extent, I like this team, Akwa United, will give us some good football.
Very good football. Akwa United, very surprising. Last season, they struggled.
Yeah.
They had to wait to the last day against Akwa United in Lokoja to escape relegation. This season, even though they allowed their topmost striker, at least for Enyimba, Ufondo, they're able to get some of the...
And it's looking like they're not missing him.
They're not missing him because they see Ukeme Davis, Emmanuel Ariwa, they see Mubonge Pai, one of their top scorers last season. They see this guy from Utebe Achibong from Akwa Starlet. So it's a loaded squad. And you expect that Patrick Udo, former first bank goalkeeper, is tinkering the team, doing a lot of work. But still early days, six week. But this is, if the league ends today, we can just see Akwa United is sure of getting to the Champions League. So... coming up against Enyimba, Enyimba is smarting from some pleasant news from the week, from the last week. Their coach was suspended, two coaches were suspended indefinitely. Mm-hmm. One of the assistant coaches, Imama, took them to worry. They got a draw.
Yeah.
So they're playing at home against Akwa United. They lost one game at home. I think they lost them against FC Taraba. They lost against Abia Warriors, the local derby. So it's just, let's see what Mama will bring to the table. Let's see what that result will be for Enyimba. Let's see whether, is it telling the coach to step aside and bring in and allowing the assistant coach to tinker the team that will give you the result, or would you allow him to come back the two coaches suspended to come back to do their job. So it's still dicey. That game will be played at the Aba Township Stadium. Enyimba has not lost, so a lot of people have been saying, but the way they lost against Akwa Abiawa, so that would give Akwa United an opportunity to say yes, even though Enyimba still are not impregnable at home. Mm-hmm. So we can still break down Enyimba. Mm-hmm. The double header in Kano Pillars taking on FC Taraba,
yeah.
And of course the Air Academy against
Lobby Stars,
double header in Kano. Big game, and we expect that. I hope when we say 50 policemen should be at the stadium, this should be 50, because I know the Kano fans. We have a double header. Kano Pillars alone have their crowd pulling team. Yeah. When they are playing at home in Kano, then let alone we have a game against we have the game between Air Academy and Lobby Stars in that game. Academy and Lobby, so it's like two put into one for the fans. So they want to get the benefit for paying to watch this game. So Academy still not able to adjust to their new home ground in Kano. So, but I hope they look at Lobby Stars game and see if they can begin to replicate some of those results we've known them to when they are playing in Faroe Maiduguri. They're not playing at their natural home ground. So for Lobby Stars, brilliant side, but this is one of the biggest tests for the Coach Evans Ogeni boys. Mm.
That's for action that will be seen in Kano. I'm also interested in that game that will be seen in Bayelsa when NB City will play Bayelsa United. We'll go on a quick break now. Let's just see pictures from that game between Bayelsa United and El Kanemi Warriors, and then we'll come back. We'll talk more about it. Stay with us.